There's something visceral about a photograph, especially an authentic photograph. And I think that I'm able to show visually the contrast between what was and what is.
The job of the chief official White House photographer is to make authentic photographs.
Photographs break down the idea that these people are somehow different from us.
I've got an idea for another picture. Did you get that piece?
Yeah.
My name is Pete Souza. I was the chief official White House photographer for President Obama. And the name of the film is The Way I See It. For me, it was always about trying to create the best body of work. The types of photographs that I like the best are the fleeting moments where you see him interacting with other people, whether that be his own kids or other kids or staff members or world leaders. Just the interplay, the interaction between him and other people. I had known President Obama for 4 years before he became president, so I had developed a professional relationship with him. And I think he, more than anyone, understood the value of having somebody visually document the presidency for history. My approach was not to change anything about what was happening. Just be ready for whatever was about to happen. And then hopefully you're doing it in such a way that your framing, your composition is good. And oftentimes you don't have much control at all over the lighting. I mean, in my case, it was always whatever available light. I mean, I didn't use a flash or auxiliary lights. So it's just trying to capture fleeting moments and hopefully that you're composing them well.
This five-year-old kid asked Obama, is my haircut just like yours? President Obama bent over and let that kid touch his head with his hand.
That image stands for how kids will see themselves differently forever.
I hope people come away after looking at the film with two things. One, the importance of having, you know, an official White House photographer document the presidency for history. But two, just a reminder of how a president is supposed to behave in office. And, you know, a message to some young people out there is that, channeling my former boss, that it's great that people are out in the streets protesting. I am inspired by them. But at the same time, if you want institutional change, you've got to get out and vote. It's not an either or proposition. You can't protest and not vote. And in order to make institutional change is to vote in the people that are the closest to where you want to go. So get on the train that's going to take you close to where you want to go.